Hello Scrappers! I decided to make a video and explain my strategy when I decide should I sell or depopulate boards. I have a simple triple rule and I've explained how it works at the end of the video. But let's start first with these nice boards that I put here on the table. You see that we have many good ICs there, BGAs of different type, four-sided, we have MLCCs, we have memory ICs here, so pretty good boards I can say. And I have 780 grams of them. What's the price? If I go today and sell these boards, I will probably get $6.60. So let's depopulate all these and see how much money in gold and possibly palladium and silver we have on these boards. I'll not waste your time to watch me scrapping all this pile, but I'll show you the final result and I'll show you my calculation, how I decide should I sell the boards or depopulate them. Let's scrap now. After 20 minutes, that's the final result. All boards depopulated. Let me show you what I took from these boards. Here it comes. Second sheet with all the elements. More or less every scrapper is taking this. BGAs, gold fingers, tantalums, MLCCs, four-sided ICs, two-sided ICs. Here is the value in these boards. But the key question of this video is how to quickly calculate the value, how to quickly decide should I scrap or should I sell the board. Let me show you the calculation that I usually do. I'll take my scale and let's together have a look at the most expensive component on these boards. These are the MLCCs. No, these are not the MLCCs. These are the BGAs. BGAs. What's the price? How much gold do we have in them? Usually when I recover gold, I get a result between 9 and 12 grams of gold per kilogram of BGAs of this side with the gold corner. Let's be conservative, 9. So this means that per today's price, we have $50 of gold in 100 grams of BGAs, or 50 cents per gram. That's my price for the quick calculation. So let's use the scale and check the weight and the value of these BGAs. So this is a relatively big one. Put it here, 4. This means more than $2 in gold. Let's take a small one, 75 cents of gold. Let's take something in between. This is $1.50. Then maybe another big one, 6 grams. So these are $3, 30 or something like this. Okay, a small one. This is 75 cents. What I did, I took these boards and I counted the BGAs and I counted the BGAs and the price, knowing more or less what is the weight of these BGAs. So I estimated the value before scrapping the boards based on the number of the BGAs and their size. But did I calculate well? Let's check now. I'll put this on top because I will load all the BGAs on top of this scale. 0. And let's check. Was my calculation correct? What's the result? I'm earning money or losing money here. Let's load even the broken ones. Broken, that's no issue because gold is in this black top. So it doesn't matter if it's broken or intact. 58.6 grams. Let's say 58 grams for easy calculation. $29 in gold. You remember when I did initial calculation, they were $6.60 if I sell these boards as scrap. I have only in these BGAs $29. So this is significantly higher value than the scrap value of the boards. But where is the border? Where I put the border and that flips the decision, scrapping or depopulating or saving the boards? For me, this border is 3 times. If the board scrap value is $6.60, I am chasing gold content for more than $20. 3 times the scrap value. Why I do this? First of all, if I sell the boards, I will get $6.60. So I want to take this money back. This is one time, $6.60. Second time, I wasted 20 minutes to depopulate. I will waste another maybe 15 minutes on average to take the gold content and everything from the boards. And last, I need a profit. So that's why I take the scrap value, the board scrap value, multiply by 3, and if I'm above, I always depopulate boards. If I'm below, I always sell the boards because there are no money inside. And last, all this is meaningless when you have volumes. If you go with 58 grams of BGAs and you process this, you'll never earn money. You have to accumulate 1 kilogram, 2 kilograms, and go for refining. Because then the time that you need to process 1 kilogram of BGAs and 58 grams of BGAs is almost the same. So the huge factor to get profit is scale. You need huge volumes. That's why most scrappers on the internet stockpile. They are depopulating and they keep all these elements until they reach certain amount. After they reach certain amount, then they start thinking about processing because it's profitable. That's my approach. And if you have any questions, don't hesitate, drop a comment. I'll do my best to reply to all the comments. Thanks for watching. Keep scrapping. And don't forget at the end, recover your gold from everything you scrap. Bye.